random. Hello? Hello? What are you guys doing? You guys are looking to run my first stream of the day. Where is she land at? Thank you. Alright, guys.
You guys? Hello?
Thank you.
Just got him.
Oh, you best be careful, buddy. I'm a sweat. Absolutely annihilated that man's world. Get out of my game, you don't deserve to be here. Shooting at me while I'm shooting a friggin' default in the distance? No, not today. Alright, we've got our first points. One for the kill, then three for placement, I guess. I wonder what happened to that default I shot at.
Shake your head. Oh. level 50. God damn. Slaying.
No, pero es que hablo en español.
Hello.
Mira, 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 tía. Aquí están hablando.
Do you know you're on my stream right now? I'm streaming on YouTube.
No, no entiendo, no entiendo. No entiendo, bien, no entiendo.
Where are we landing?
En español, por favor. En español, en Spanish, por favor. Ah, no manches, acabo de echar un sapo. ¡Qué puerco! ¡Acabo de echar un sapo! ¡Ah! ¡Echar un sapo!
Bro, are you still there? Hello? Hello?
Hello.
All right. You need that other dude. He's freaking annoying. Do you know you're on my stream right now? I just started like a couple minutes ago, so I don't have any. Nobody joined. Well, it only says one viewer, but that's me because I have my laptop. Because I have to see if I need to edit. I got an Evelyn. Wanna pump? Hey bro, who wants a pump? Snap. You still there? Do you want a pump? All of Bongo. All of Bongo. Bro, you still there? Hello? Bro, you still talking? Monville.
¿Verdad que ya? ¿Verdad que ayer me vestí de duende navideño?
What drugs are you on?
De duende navideño.
What drugs are you on?
Mira, con ese gorro y con lentes bien chavos y verdes.
What drugs are you on?
Yo espero ahorita me cambio, va. Me transformo. ¿En duende?
¿Y no has descargado
los juegos? No. Ahorita los
quiero
creer, mi hermano. ¿Eh? A un youtuber, a ver, está todo el que tenga buenas compras y las compra.
It was a simple question to that dude Monville, what drugs are you on? Because he's freaking talking a language that probably doesn't even exist.
Snakes. Snakes.
Launch pad on me. Did anybody even come here? A hell of ammo. Somebody came here, they probably don't know how to loot. It's up like a oh, damn.
Yo, what's up? Welcome back. How's everybody doing? Today, we're doing a nice banger for you boys. We got the $110 big versus the $10 each of you. Look at these cool things. The little disposable fucking neon smoke. That's cool. So we're going to be comparing the two different type of vapes that you could roll. 7% pods. I forgot to mention that. These are.
You know that you're in my stream right now on YouTube?
No, I do. I don't even know where everybody's going.
I'm going Mega Mall. Bro, where the hell did these people come from?
Fries. Why are you guys always fighting, punk? Trippy? What did I tell you about hotboxing the freezer?
Ask it!
Alright. It's a new day. I'm sure things will be better today. 21. 21. You're working in the kitchen tonight, alright?
21.
Alright. You're in charge of scooping fries. It's very simple.
Teen boy missing for 3 years finally returns home, but everything is not as it seems. Before we begin, do us a favor and click that like button. Also subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell to be inspired by these heartwarming stories every day. It's inevitable to feel extremely worried whenever a person goes missing. Friends and family members want to keep the faith alive for as long as possible until they can finally find some sort of end to it. May it be something they do not wish to hear, or something to celebrate about. Sometimes the closure they receive is too good to be the actual truth. When a young boy from Texas went missing in 1994, his family was devastated. A few years later, however, he was found in a different country. His family was surprised by the turn of events, but it soon turned out that not all was the same as before. Nicholas Barclay from San Antonio, Texas, had a troubled family life. According to those closest to him, he frequently argued with his parents and teachers, and he would often act out aggressively towards those around him. Nicholas even got himself into enough trouble that he had a court hearing scheduled due to his dire behavior. Little did his family know that Nicholas would never make it to hearing. The boy even went out to the hospital to meet his friends at the court he was scheduled to be in court. After the game, all of his friends returned home, but Nicholas was too seedy yet. Suspicious. Charlie didn't believe the kidnappers were physically able to change the boy's eye color. Also, if what Nicholas said was true, the unfortunate events he went through would have most certainly caused him to become withdrawn. But that wasn't the case at all. Charlie and the other investigators closely examined photos of before and after the little kidnapper. Besides the eye and hair change, he noticed one more difference that resulted in an alarming breakthrough. It was his ears. Ears are completely unique to an individual, similar to that of a fingerprint, and apparently this young man's ears didn't match the boy who had disappeared 3 years earlier. But if the person they found wasn't Nicholas Barclay, who exactly were the investigators talking to? Turns out he was a 23-year-old French man named Frederick Borden, who was posing as the 16-year-old boy. Frederick was also known as the Chameleon by Interpol, the world's largest police organization. Frederick was a wanted criminal who impersonated missing children, and over the course of his life, he had used hundreds of different identities and personalities, his most recent being Nicholas Barclay. Frederick got the idea to impersonate the missing boy when the Spanish police who found him said that he bore a striking resemblance. That was all he needed to hear to pull up.
Thank you.
fucking dumbasses. Fuck. Because I have to end the broadcast. I'll see you later today. I'm going to try to start making some really banger videos. Alright, peace out.